What's up guys, Sal here. So Google made the Pixel 5 official yesterday, which is their flagship offering for this year. The phone comes with improvements over the last year's Pixel 4, such as a better camera, a bigger battery, wireless and reverse wireless charging. The phone is also made up of aluminum, which is a welcome change. It's been a while we haven't seen a metal phone. People have been complaining about the glass, especially how fragile it is. It seems Google listened to the feedback and made their phone stronger with a metal back. Now, I know what some of you are thinking. This phone has a metal back and at the same time has wireless charging too. How is this even possible? I mean, for years, smartphone companies were forced to use glass and plastic back for wireless charging to work. The metal cannot pass the wireless charging signals, and that's the reason companies stopped using it years ago. But Google has found a workaround. What they are doing on the Pixel 5 is they're absolutely using the aluminum back, but they have created a hole in the middle where the wireless charging coil is placed. Now, on top of this aluminum chassis and wireless charging coil, they've applied another layer of a material that Google likes to call bioresin, which by the way is a fancy name for plastic. So basically, there's aluminum chassis with a big hole in the middle with the wireless charging coil, and on top of all of this, there's a very thin plastic layer applied. So when holding the device in your hand, you'll feel the plastic, not the metal. This technique allowed them to use metal and wireless charging at the same time, which is smart as it gives the handset a sturdy and rigid structure. Android Authority asked Google why exactly they went with this approach. The answer they got is a weird one, because Google said they did it to maintain the thinness of the phone. Since the Pixel 5 has a bigger battery, so in order to maintain the same thickness as last year, they had to do this aluminum super thin plastic design. Anyway, when you look at the front of the Pixel 5, you can see the bezels all around is actually thin. I mean, look at the chin. It has to be one of the thinnest out there. It even looks thinner than the iPhones, which really surprises me because Google isn't known for their designs. But I gotta admit, the Pixel 5 looks good, at least from the front. Also, Google has confirmed to The Verge that the Soli radar and motion sense will come back in the future. They didn't specify when, but said that the reason they didn't include the radar chip on the Pixel 5 is due to the price. I mean, the chip is very expensive, and they wanted to keep the price of the Pixel 5 competitive and decided to skip the feature this year. The way motion sense worked on the Pixel 4, I don't think anyone would ever miss that feature. Unless Google can make it work as they have shown in this video, I think it's best for them to not use the chip, as it not only increases the component cost, but will also provide gimmicky features that most Pixel users will stop using day after getting the phone. In any case, let me know what you think. Is $699 a bit too much for what the Pixel 5 offers? Let me know down in the comments. And as always, I'll see you tomorrow. Peace out.